our best and present to the Greek public, both directly.
It's not my son. You know, my son is dead.
Lined up in and I'm 26. My brother Leviatar is 22. He will celebrate 23 by the end of December. 6:30 in the morning, we woke up to the sound of sirens. In Israel, it means that we have to run to the bomb shelter because they've been shooting rockets on us, so we woke up and ran. And my mom, immediately she started texting my brother, are we okay, what's going on? And he said, the festival is over, we are running away to the car, and don't worry. The last message we got from him was about 7:45 a.m. The only thing we had to do at that moment was pray. And my sister, she's very, very clever. She posted on Instagram a photo of my brother with the phone.
Okay.
You can see his smile. He's energetic. Always smile on his face. Friendly. Sociable. Loved by people. Taking life easy. Last time I saw my son, it was on October 6th. Video clip. The Hamas published in the Telegram. I recognized my son immediately. He was lying on the floor before our garden guys. His hands on his face. He was frightened. Frightened.
Escape. After a few meters, they had to stop because bullets of the Hamas stopped them. And they escaped for another direction. For the two girls escaped to one direction to hear our story. We'd like to take a picture of Almog's picture and can bring the story worldwide. We want to achieve two goals. We want to know something about Almog and all the other kids back home. They can't handle themselves.
A situation that we will do anything it takes to bring them back home. We are willing to sign a contract with the devil if we need to. Right now, the only thing that we are interested in is to bring them back home.
And we believe that it's important that the Greek public opinion will be aware of what has happened in Israel and what is happening now, and will assist in every possible way in bringing the kidnapped back home.